हाय स्टूडेंट्स, विजय लक्ष्मी मैम हियर। विल बी कंटिन्यूइंग विद द कार्ल्स पियर्सन कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ कोरिलेशन। इन द लास्ट वीडियो द टू मेजरमेंट्स ऑफ फाइंडिंग द कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ कोरिलेशन, दैट इज स्कैटर डायग्राम मेथड वाज डन एंड द कार्ल्स पियर्सन वाज स्टार्टेड एंड वी हैड कंप्लीटेड द प्रॉब्लम्स for the ungrouped data. Now we'll be doing problems for the grouped data. Now consider the first problem. The question says calculate the coefficient of correlation between the number of male children and the number of female children from the following data. Table is number of male children and number of female children. Zero number of female, one number of female, two number of female, three and four number of female, zero male, one, two, three and four. So this is the question they give you. They give you a complete table along with the values. So here we have 3, 4, 2 and there are no values here, 4, 8, 8, 2, no value here, 7, 12, 8, 4, 3, 8, 8, 5, 3, 5, 6. These are the values been given with the table. So asked question, they give you the question in the tabular format. Now when they give you the question in the tabular format, or if the data is in the form of grouped form, then you are supposed to make use of the second formula which I had given you in the previous video, that is R is equal to capital letter N summation x y f x y minus summation x fx into summation y fy whole divided by square root of capital letter N into summation x square fx minus summation x fx the whole square into capital letter N summation y square fy minus summation y fy the whole square. So you are supposed to make use of this formula if the question is given in terms of the table, that is the tabulated data or for the grouped data. Now this is the question and this is the formula you are supposed to use for your solution. Now how exactly we solve, what is the procedure, I'll explain it to you. It's quite easy. Only thing is you need to understand the logic behind it. Okay. So the same question has to be written in a table form. Okay. So you are rewriting the question in the table again. So for the solution, you have number of male children and number of female children been given, that I'll be representing in terms of x and y respectively. So that is number of male children, I put it as x, and the number of female children I put it as y. So we draw a bigger table. So these are for the x values, and in the question you can see that for the number of female child you have 0 value, next you have 1 value, you have 2 number of female, 3 number of female and 4 number of female. So this is the question, and for the male, 0 male, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So write the values as it is. So 0 male and 0 female, we have 3, next 4, next is 2. There are no values here, leave blank. Next is 4, 8, 8, 2, blank, blank, 7, 12, 8, 4, blank, 3, 8, 8, 5, blank, blank, 3, 5, and 6. So this is the table which I have rewritten. And next, the first column, what you take here is fx. Fx is nothing but the total, that is the row wise totals. 4 plus 3 is 7, plus 2, it is 9. So this is just the total, what I do. Next, 4 plus 8 plus 8 plus 2, it is 22. Next, 7 plus 12 plus 8 plus 4, it is 32. 3 plus 8 plus 8 plus 5, it is 24. Next, 3 plus 5 plus 6, it is 14. Okay, similarly, do fy total. So this total is nothing but the column total. This total, the first column, 3 plus 4 is 7, 4 plus 8 plus 7 plus 3 is 22, 2 plus 8 plus 12 plus 8 plus 3 is 33, next is 23, and next is 15. I guess I'm clear. You're rewriting the question, then taking the column total and the row total. The row total you're giving it as fx, and the column total you are giving it as fy. Next, look into the next column. It is x, fx. So we all know that this is x and this is the fx. So we multiply this with this. 0 into 9 is 0, 1 into 22 is 22, 2 into 32 is 60. Three into 24 is 72. 4 into 14 is 56. Sorry, this is 31. And 2 into 31 is 62. Right now, similarly, do y f y. So we all know that this is y and this is fy. Multiply 0 into 7 is 0, 1 into 22 is 22, 2 into 33 is 66, 3 into 23 is 69, 4 into 15 is 60. Right? Now, take the total here, summation of this, this, and also this and this. So summation effects total is 100. That is 9 plus 22 plus 31 plus 24 plus 14. Similarly, 7 plus 22 plus 33 plus 23 plus 15 will again give you 100. So this total and this total will always be the same, and this is the value of capital letter N. Next, take the summation of this x fx. So this 0 plus 22 plus 62 plus 72 plus 56. It is 212. Similarly, take the total of this 22 plus 66 plus 69 plus 60. It is 270. All these things are required at the time of substitution. Now, the next column what we put is x square fx. Okay. Similarly, here take y square fy. So x square is this. So the next column is x square fx. So x square is here. This other x value fx is here. So x square, x value is 0, 0 square is 0, 0 into 9 is again 0. 1 square is 1, 1 into 22 is 22. 2 square is 4, 4 into 31 is 124. 3 square is 9, 9 into 72 is 9 into 24, fx is 24, so 9 into 24 is 216. Next, 4 into 4, it is 16, into fx is 14, so we have 224. Okay, now take the total of this 22 plus 124 plus 216 plus 224, so you get 86 as the total. Next, similarly, y square fy. This is the y values. So y square, 0 square is 0, 0 into 7 is 0, 1 square is 1 into 22 is 22, 2 square is 4, 4 into 33, it is 132. So 3 square is 9, 9 into 23 is 207. Next is 4 square, it is 16 into 15, it is 240. Now take the total of all 22 plus 132 plus 207 plus 240. So you get 601 as the total. Next is very important, that is xy fxy. Next is xy fxy. So this you can either do it in the column part or you can do it in the row part. It is left to you. If you want it on the both the side, you can do it on the both the side. Now be very careful and listen, how do we find this very important part. Now take this fy, sorry, this part. You have x into y, f x y. So this is x and this is y. Take the x value, take the y value, multiply. 0 into 0 is 0. This has to be multiplied with the number here. 0 into 3 is 0. 0 into 1 is 0. 0 into 4 is 0. 0 into 2 is 0. 0 into 2 is 0. So these two no values, leave as it is. Next, 1 into 0 is 0. 0 into 4 is 0. 1 into 1 is 1. 1 into 8 is 8. 1 into 2 is 2. 2 into 8 is 16. Next, 1 into 3 is 3. 3 into 2 is 6. No values, leave as it is. 2 into 0 is 0. You need not calculate anything here because you don't have any value. 2 into 1 is 2. 2 into 7 is 14. 2 into 2 is 4. X 4 into 12 is 48. 2 into 3 is 6. Next, 6 into 8. 48. 2 into 4 is 8. 8 into 4 is 32. Next, I have value 3 for x. There's no value here, so you need not calculate anything. 3 into 1 is 3. 3 into 3 is 9. 3 into 2 is 6. 6 into 8 is 48. Now, 3 into 3 is 9. 9 into 8 is 72. 3 into 4 is 12. 12 into 5 is 60. Next, there are no values here. Next is this 4 into 2. Take this column, row value and this column value. 4 into 2 is 8. 8 into 3 is 24. 3 into 4 is 12. 12 into 5 is 60. 4 into 4 is 16. 16 into 6 is 96. No. Take the total, whatever you have put this in the box. 0 plus 0 plus 0. It is 0. 8 plus 16 plus 6. 8 plus 16 plus 6. It is 30. Next, 14 plus 48 plus 48 plus 32. It is 142. Next is 9 plus 48 plus 72 plus 60. It is 189. Next, 24 plus 60 plus 96. You get 180. Now take the total of all this. It is 30 plus 142 plus 189 plus 180. Get 541. Now similarly, do for the column. 0 plus 0 is 0. 8 plus 14 plus 9. 8 plus 14 plus 9. It is 31. Next, 0 plus 16 plus 48 plus 48. Next, 6 plus 48 plus 72 plus 60, 186. 32 plus 60 plus 96, 188. Take the total of all this. 188 plus 186 plus 136 plus 31. You again get the total as 541. Always this and this will be the same. If you find any difference among them, then there's something wrong you have made in the calculation. So be very careful when you're solving this. Next, we have found all the values. Next, you're supposed to substitute it in the formula. So as we know, the formula is capital letter n into summation xy fxy minus summation x fx into summation y fy whole divided by square root of n into summation x square fx minus summation x fx the whole square into n into summation y square fy minus summation y fy the whole square. Now substitute all the values here. What is n? It is 100 into summation fx y into x into y is 541 minus summation x fx is 212 into summation y fy is 217 whole divided by square root of n is 100 into summation x square fx is 586 into summation x fx square x fx is 212 the whole square. This into 100 into x square fx is 601 into summation y fy the whole square fy is 217 the whole square. This has to be within the range. So this is 54100 minus 212 into 217 is 46004 whole divided by square root of 58600 minus 212 the whole square is 44944 into 217 into 217 the whole square. This is 100 into 601 is 601000. So 217 the whole square is 47089. So simplify this, you get 8096 divided by square root of 13656 into 13011. So 8096 whole divided by, when you multiply this and take the root, you get 13329 minus 598, so which is equal to 0.6074. So this is the coefficient of correlation among the variable x and y. This is the value. This is how you solve this problem. I guess I am clear with it. Next, we'll continue with the same type of tabulated problem, but the data is in terms of grouped form here. In the previous problem, the data was given in a tabulated form, but there was no grouped data. But here, in this question, you have grouped data, and how do you solve it? I'll be teaching you. So, question, calculate Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation from the following data and comment on the result. The table they give you is, this is y, this is x. So you have value 80 to 90, 90 to 100, 100 to 110, 110 to 120. Here it is 40 to 44, 44 to 48, 48 to 52, 52 to 56, 56 to 60. Two, four, 4 minus 3, 4, 1. It's not minus, sorry. It's a blank dash. This is the given question. You can notice that the data what they have given you is in group form. So how do you solve this? Again, the table has to be repeated in the same format, but the value of x and y will be different. Now the solution for this is, again you are supposed to frame the table. This is for y and this is for x. You have the values for x and y in the group form. First, we'll fill the x values. So, in the question, they have given you the value is from 40 to 44. You're supposed to write the midpoint values. Now, how do you calculate the midpoint value? Is 40 plus 44 divided by 2. It is 42. Next, 44 plus 48. Divided by 2, it is 46. The next values you can write it directly because we have difference of 4 here. So next will be 50. If you want, you can calculate it again. That is 48 plus 52 divided by 2, or you can write it directly. So the next value will be 54, or 52 plus 56 divided by 2, and 56 plus 60 divided by 2 will be 58. Now these are your x values. Similarly, do the y value. In the y, you have 80 to 90. So 80 plus 90 divided by 2. You get 85. Next is 90 to 100. So 90 plus 100 divided by 2. It is 95. The next values you can write directly. So there's difference of 10. So the next will be 105, and the next will be 115. Take the values, add. So it is 2, 2, 4, 7, no value. 2, 3, 4, no value. 4, 5, 1, 2. 6, 4, no value. 3, 4, 1, no value. Now similarly, find the total fx and fy here. So fx is the total of all this. That's the row wise total. 2 plus 2 plus 4 plus 7. It is 15. Next is 9. Next is 10. Next is 12. Next is 8. Hope I'm clear. 2 plus 3 plus 4 is 9. 4 plus 5 plus 1 is 10. 6 plus 4 plus 2 is 12. 3 plus 4 plus 1 is 9. Now take the total of this. That is the n value. That is nothing but 54. Similarly, add up all this. 2 plus 4 plus 3 is 7. 2 plus 2 plus 4 plus 6 plus 4 is 18. 4 plus 3 plus 5 plus 4 is 17. 7 plus 4 plus 1 is 12. Now take the total of this. 7 plus 18 plus 17 plus 12, you again get 54. So this sum has to be the same for all the problems. Next, you have to find u here. Now what is u? It is ufx here. Why u? Because you have been given with a grouped data. In the previous problem, there was single data. The data was not grouped. So you had taken xfx. But here, you have to take u and v. U for the x values and v for the y values. And what is u? U is nothing but the value x minus a divided by c. So I will take it as cx. Now what is a? A is some value which has to be subtracted from x. Okay, so that is the assumed value. Now you can notice that in x we have 42, 46, 50, 54 and 58. Among this you can take any value as an assumed value, but I'll be taking the middle value as the assumed value here. So I take 50 as a. Okay, and what is cx? Cx is the difference what we have from the first with the second for any two values. So you can notice we have a difference of 4 here. So x minus a divided by cx. So x is 42 minus a is 50. So 42 minus 50 is minus 8 divided by the difference is 4. So you get the value as minus 2. So this is 50 and this is 4. Next, 46 minus 50 divided by 4. This minus 1. So 50 minus 50 is 0. 54 minus 50 is 4. 4 divided by 4 is 1. 58 minus 50 is 8. 8 divided by 4 is plus 2. So when you take the total of this, it comes to 0. Or you don't require this total of u in our formula. So we don't add that. Similarly, do all the column values. This for y. So I take this as v. Now what is v? V is y minus b divided by cy. V is some assumed value of y. So in my example or in my problem, I take 95 is the value of v. And cy is the difference, the constant difference what we have among the values. 85 and 95, the difference is 10. So it is b is y minus b is 95 divided by c y is 10. So now 85 minus 95 is minus 10 divided by 10 is minus 1. 95 minus 95 is 0. 105 minus 95 is plus 10. Plus 10 divided by 10 is 1. 115 minus 95 is 20 and divided by 10 is 2. We again don't require the total of this in any of our formula, so we don't take the total of this. So next is u fx. Now we know this is u and this is fx. Okay, multiply this and this. So 15 into minus 2 is minus 30, minus 9, 0, 12 and 16. So ufx is required in our formula, the total of it. So minus 9, 30, minus 9 plus 12 plus 16 will give you minus 11. Similarly, do here v f y, take the total. Next, this is v and f y is this. 7 into minus 1 is minus 7. 18 into 0 is 0. 17 into 1 is 17. 12 into 2 is 24. So minus 7 plus 17 plus 24 is 30. Okay. Next, we require u square fx. So what is u square fx? This is u fx and this is u. So u into u is u square fx. So you will be multiplying these two, u into u fx, to get u square fx. That is minus 2 into minus 30 is plus 60. Minus 1 into minus 9 is plus 9. 0, 1 into 12 is 12. 16 is 32. Hope I'm clear. Similarly, v square fy. So again, v fy into v. So that becomes v square fy. So you will be multiplying these two columns. Rows. Minus 7 into minus 1 is plus 7. 0 into 0 is 0. 17 into 1 is 17. 24 into 2 is 48. Now take the total of this, that is 7 plus 17 plus 48, get the total as 72. The total of u square fx is 113, that is 60 plus 9 plus 12 plus 32. Hope I am clear till here. Now u require u v f x y, and here it is u v f x y. So now again, now what you do is you have to take look into the u column and you have to look into the v values. So this is the u column and this is the v row. This is u into v. Okay, so where you have u and where you have v, just look into it. Next, take the product of this minus 1 into minus 2. So when I join, it comes here. So minus 1 into minus 2 is plus 2. 2 into 2 is 4. Similarly, 0 into minus 2, it comes here. 0 into 0 is 0. 0 into anything is again 0. Now 1 into minus 2 is minus 2. 4 into minus 2 is minus 8. Now again 2 into minus 2 is minus 4. 4 minus 4 into 7 is minus 28. I guess I'm clear. Next, go on for the second value of u again, and again from the beginning of first value of v. So minus 1 into minus 1, so it is plus 1, there's no value, leave it blank. Next, 0 into minus 1 is 0. 0 into 2 is again 0. 1 into minus 1 is minus 1. Minus 1 into 3 is minus 3. 2 into minus 1 is minus 2. Minus 2 into 4 is 8. Minus 8. Next, there's no value here, leave it. Next, here 0 into 0 is 0. 0 into 4 is 0. Next, 1 into 0 is 0. So this will again be 0. Next, 1 into 0 is 0. 1 into, sorry, 2 into 0 is 0. 1 into 0 is 0. There are no values. Next, for this, minus 1 into 1 is minus 1. Minus 1 into 2 is minus 2. 0 into 1 is 0. 0 into 6 is 0. 1 into 1 is 1. 1 into 4 is 4. No value, leave it. Next, here, minus 1 into 2 is minus 2. Minus 2 into 3 is minus 6. 0 into 2 is 0. And 4 into 0 is 0. 1 into 2 is 2. 1 into 2 is again 2. No value. Leave it as it is. Alright. I guess I'm clear here. You're supposed to look into the u and the v value and multiply these values. Put it in the cells where they meet. And then multiply with the number. Now, filling this u, v, f, x, y, you are supposed to take the total of the values that is put inside the box. That is 4 plus minus 8 plus minus 28. So it is minus 32. Next, 0 plus minus 3 plus minus 8. It is minus 11. Everything is 0, 0. Minus 2 and plus 4 is 2. Minus 6 plus 0 plus 2 is minus 4. So when I take the total of this, we have minus 45. Next, take the total of all the column here. 4 plus minus 2 plus minus 6. It is minus 4. All the values are 0. Next, minus 8 plus minus 3 plus 4 plus 2 is minus 5. Minus 28 minus 8 is minus 36. Take the total of this, you get minus 45. These two values has to be same. So now, substitute it in the formula. Now what is the formula? R is equal to N into summation u v f x y minus summation u f x into summation v f y. Since you have grouped the data, you don't have x and y here, instead you have u and v. So now what is u? It is x minus a divided by cx, and what is v? That is y minus b divided by cy. What is that we have seen in the table. And next, it is n into summation u square fx minus summation u fx the whole square into n summation v square fy minus summation v fy the whole square. So you are supposed to substitute it here. The value of n from the table is 54. Summation uv fxy is minus 45 minus of summation u fx is minus 11, summation v fy is 34. 4 divided by square root of n is again 54 into summation u square fx is 113. Minus 11 the whole square, minus 11 the whole square into 54 into 72 minus 34 the whole square. So when you simplify, you get minus 2430, that is 54 into minus 45 is minus 2430 plus this is minus into minus, so it becomes plus 11 into 34 is 374. 4 divided by 54 into 113 is 6102 minus minus 11 the whole square is plus 121 into 54 into 72 is 3888 minus 34 square is 1156. So now when you subtract this, you get minus 2056. You need to subtract because one number is positive and the other is negative. Even though you have a plus sign, you will be subtracting the value with a negative sign because the higher value is with a negative sign. So 6120 minus 121 is 5981 into 3888 minus 1156 2732. So one simplification, you get minus 2056 4 divided by 4042.2879. So when you divide this number, you get minus 0.5068. Now you can notice that you have a negative value, so it is a negative correlation. And for the comment, there exists higher negative correlation that exists between the variable x and y. So this is the comment. Yes, I am clear till here. Okay, students. For now, I want you all to try this problem, and you people have any doubts solving this problem, please do contact me. Take the question. The following table gives the frequency according to age groups and marks obtained by 67 students in an intelligent test. Calculate Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation between age and intelligence. Test marks age in years, 18 years, 19, 20, 21, test marks 200 to 250, 250 to 300, 300 to 350, 350 to 400. 4, 4, 2, 1, 3, 5, 4, 2, 2, 6, 8, 5, 1, 4, 6, 10. Now, this is the given question. I want all of you to try this. If in case you have any doubts, please do contact me. Now, I'll just give you the hint here. For the solution, you'll be making use of the second type of formula. R is equal to n summation u v f x y minus summation u f x into summation v f y all divided by square root of n into summation u square f x minus summation u f x the whole square into n summation v square f y minus summation v f y the whole square. So this formula you are supposed to use and solve the problem. Now what is again u v? U is x minus a divided by c x and v is y minus b divided by c y. Now you can notice that there are individual values out for the ages and for the test marks you have the class intervals been given. So when you frame the table for the solution, you are supposed to find the midpoints only for the test marks and maintain the values 18, 19, 20 and 21 as it is. Okay, I guess I'm clear with this. So please do try the problem and let me know if you have any doubts. Thank you.